하나님의
All the
세원이야.
believers,
계시록
including pastors,
예언과
theology
성취의 증거.
students, who
신천지
are in attendance
온라인
of this 신천지 online seminar, testimony on prophecy and fulfillment of Revelation, God's new covenant, welcome. My name is Kim Shin-chang, the moderator today. First, I'd like to thank everyone who's joining us today for this 신천지 online seminar.
오늘
신천지 online seminar, titled Testimony and Prophecy and Fulfillment of Revelation, God's New Covenant, will be broadcast worldwide in various languages. To everyone who's joining us from many different parts of the world, I'd like to say welcome. This seminar is a great opportunity for every believer in this world to understand not only the prophecies of the Book of Revelation, but also the conclusion and reality of its fulfillment. I truly pray that all those who are in attendance today will receive huge grace and deep perception. And first, let us offer up a prayer before we begin the seminar. Let us pray with a united heart. Our Father, who is the Most Holy, we sincerely thank you so much for your huge grace of being with us and allowing us to open up worldwide the Shincheonji Online Seminar on the topic of testimony on prophecy and fulfillment of Revelation, God's new covenant. What the whole world yearns for and is waiting for is you, Lord God. All of us were guided here through various ways, but we believe we are all here together because of our desire to know you more and so that we can listen to the testimony of Revelation. Please open up our hearts, and please open up our eyes and ears, so that we can truly perceive what you promised in the scriptures, the book of Revelation that contains the conclusion and its completion. Please help us to fully hear and perceive during this time. Today is the first day of the seminar series, and going further, we will receive the testimony of Revelation over 20 times. Please let no one fall from listening to these words midway, but help all of us to run and finish the race so that no one will miss out on this precious word of yours. Please also be with our chairman, who'll be testifying today, and please clothe him with the wisdom that comes from your Holy Spirit, and may this be a time we receive deep perception through the work of your Holy Spirit. We truly believe that you will guide every part of this seminar. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
네, 온라인으로 진행하는 This seminar has been conducted with strict adherence to the government's COVID-19 and social distancing regulations. Now I will introduce the next part of our seminar. As you know, even in the world when two people meet for the first time, they each greet one another and introduce themselves to each other. Who will be our first speaker in sharing the word with us today? We prepared a short video introduction of the speaker of God's word today, the chairman of Shincheonji Church of Jesus, Lee Man-hee. I'd like to introduce to you Mr. Lee Man-hee, the chairman of Shincheonji Church, the messenger of Jesus promised in the Book of Revelation, who is continuing his journey as a messenger of peace globally. Let's watch the video together. Jesus chose me and showed all that has been fulfilled from Revelation chapters 1 to 22. He sent me to the churches to testify to everything I saw and heard.
Thank you.
Yes, now the most important time has come, and that is the time to listen to the word of life. This is not the first time Shincheonji Church has done a seminar on the topic of Revelation. Just as you have seen in the video prior, ever since the establishment of Shincheonji in 1984, we went throughout the entire country and held Word of Revelation seminars. In particular, in 2019, we held seminars across major cities in the country on the topic of the Second Coming and confirming the harvest. Every time the Word of Revelation was testified to, there were so many believers who came forward to the promises of God. This year, I am honored to be here with all of you online. I will first introduce to all of you Chairman Lee Man-hee of Shincheonji Church of Jesus, the Temple of the Tabernacle of the Testimony, who will be sharing the prophecies of Revelation and its fulfillment with all of you. The chairman, who has lived for God and Jesus all his life, has never been a believer with general thoughts. He started his life of faith under the guidance of a star and built the Church of Shincheonji with God's word for 38 years, sometimes even risking his own life. In addition, the reason why Shincheonji was able to be established according to the word, without adding to or subtracting from it, is because he is the appointed messenger from Jesus, as shown in Revelation 22:16. Furthermore, following Jesus, who proclaimed peace on earth 2,000 years ago and preached the revelation of the Old Testament, he has been working as a global peace activist. The chairman of Shincheonji Church of Jesus and Heavenly Culture World Peace and Restoration of Light has toured the globe more than 30 times, delivering and presenting the answer to peace given from heaven. The chairman, who will testify to the words of Revelation 1 today, is the only person under the heavens who can testify to the book of Revelation with the most certainty without adding to or subtracting from it. This is possible because it was not learned from seminary or from someone else. Instead, it was learned from Jesus, whom you believe and look up to. More than anything, the chairman is a believer who desires heaven like you. He has always said, "Heaven is not a place we go to alone, but a place we go to together." He has said, "If what we teach in Shincheonji is incorrect, then to please, in turn, teach us." I believe the chairman who preaches the word with such confidence is a true shepherd of God and the promised shepherd whom Jesus sent for the churches. Chapter 1 of Revelation, which the chairman will speak about today, is the chapter that summarizes the core and conclusion of the entire book of Revelation, and the chapter where the events of Revelation begin. I pray that you have a time full of grace as you put the words of the book of Revelation, verse by verse, in your heart with expectation and hope. Then, we will have the messenger of Jesus, Chairman Lee Man-hee of Shincheonji Church of Jesus. Please join me in welcoming him with a big round of applause. Yes, various religious leaders from all over the world. Hello, how are you? It is a pleasure to meet you. My name is Lee Man-hee, a Christian living in Korea. I am standing here today to testify to what I have seen and heard. There are also 12 tribe leaders who are with me by my side. Together with them, we will share the full book of Revelation in its entirety to you. The book of Revelation is a revelation that was given by Jesus. This book was recorded by Jesus' disciple John. Furthermore, Revelation is a prophecy of future events that will fulfill. At the time, Apostle John recorded this revelation he received as a vision. Thus, it is not the reality. Instead, it was just prophecies. The reason to why I was able to speak the word of truth globally was not a result of my own thoughts. It is because God and Jesus have commanded me to go and testify to the churches everything that was seen and heard. This is why the word of revelation is being conveyed to you online like this. The words of revelation I'm testifying to are not prophecies like the revelation Apostle John had. Instead, the meanings of the prophecies and the reality to those prophecies is what I am making known to the churches worldwide today. Everyone, what is recorded in the book of Revelation? It has been 2,000 years since it has been recorded. However, there is not a single person in this world who understands this small book containing 22 chapters. This is why I would like to make known what was seen and heard regarding this little book of Revelation, since the prophecies in them have fulfilled today here on earth. I ask you, please listen well. And if there's something you believe is incorrect or find difficult to understand, please feel free to contact us and we will make sure to respond. I would like to personally briefly introduce myself before I proceed. I was a farmer who worked on a farm in the countryside. I previously did not carry out a life of faith. But how did I come to believe? Also, you might be wondering how I came to see the fulfillment of Revelation. I'm sure you are curious. After I was discharged from the army, I worked on a farm in the countryside and stayed at a large farmland where I built my own farm. However, every time my grandfather prayed morning and evening to God, and I prayed beside him together when I was very young, I would remember that, and I prayed morning and evening at the field behind the house. Till this day, I do not remember what kind of prayer I really prayed. It was merely that I heard from my grandfather that there is a God who lives in heaven, believed in God, and worked hard before God, and I believed everything would go well. That's what I heard. Therefore, back when I was a young child, I prayed morning and evening with the thought of praying with my grandfather. But one night, while I was praying, there was a star, the size bigger than me, extremely bright, that appeared. I would say approximately 7 meters in size. So I was very confused. The big star appeared so bright that it was hard to see, and I was so confused, I did not know what to do. So I went home and woke my father, who was sleeping. I said, "Father, Father, a star has come, a star. A star has come." I spoke very fast. My father, who was asleep, got up, and after coming out, he too was very shocked and surprised. He said, "Wow, the star is very big. That's very bright. Wow, it's very big." And my father was shocked as well. And he continues saying, in the old days, when talented people appeared, stars appeared. And I think talented people will appear in our country as well. That evening, to the evening of 3 days after, a great star came. Then, following the guidance of that star, I went up to the mountain, drew blood before the Lord, and promised God that I would believe in Him and follow Him, carrying out a life of faith. Yes, I did. But in what way did I carry out my life of faith? Unlike the one who was exiled to the island of Patmos and saw the revelation of Jesus in a vision, I saw the reality to the fulfillment of the book of Revelation. From Revelation chapters 1 to 22, seeing all this, what was I supposed to do? I'm a person who knows nothing but farming, who worked in the countryside. I'm not even a pastor. I did not even graduate seminary. Also, I've never been evangelized by anyone. What should someone like me, who's like this, do now? But I couldn't put into words everything I saw and heard. Everyone, sometimes there are times I see, hear, and learn from God. And there are things I hear also from Jesus. However, that's not the problem. I was told to go to the churches and testify to what I have seen and heard. But there are so many churches and pastors globally. How could I possibly tell them all? I went round and round around the globe for the work of world peace and restoration of peace. I went to many countries to carry out a peace movement, telling them we should work together to end global wars and achieve peace and restoration together. I went around the world 31 times for this purpose. However, I could not deliver these words of revelation. That's why if you ask those who met me, including all the presidents I've met, if you ask them if I taught them the Bible, they would say I did not. It's because I couldn't. Even if I tried, they would not be able to understand. And if I did, they probably would not even have believed. That is why I didn't talk about it. I just did the work of peace. So I went around the world and did the work of peace. However, I wanted to share this to all our religious leaders worldwide, because after being appointed by God and Jesus and showing all the things of Revelation and commanding me to testify to these things to the churches, I felt that if I didn't do what I was commanded, it would be committing sin. That is why I wanted to share all this to the religious leaders. So what is the method that will be used to testify? Well, it will be through myself and the 12 tribe leaders. Through them, we desire to share to all the people of the world through videos. And so that the religious leaders can hear all that I am sharing. This will be broadcasted worldwide. I will do chapter 1 of Revelation, and the 12 tribe leaders will take one chapter at a time and finish up to Revelation chapter 22. This testimony was not seen in a vision like John, the disciple of Jesus. But the prophecies that were seen in visions became flesh and manifested into reality. That's what we are testifying to. It is a reality that was seen and being testified to. God must also fulfill the prophecies of the book of Revelation for everything to complete, isn't it? Since I was shown all the fulfillment of Revelation from chapters 1 to 22, the 12 tribe leaders who also saw these facts have now perceived it and can thus testify to it now. That is why I want to inform the religious leaders of each country of the world about the entirety of the book of Revelation, united together with the 12 tribe leaders. So I ask you, please listen well, as this is not man's work. What was prophesied about 2,000 years ago has been fulfilled today on the earth. In Korea, a country of the East at the ends of the earth. This is what I desire to make known. Yes, I do. In the book of Revelation, God, Jesus, and the angels of heaven appear. Not only that, the organization of evil, the group of the dragon, and their organizations also appear too. Also, there are those who rebel. Furthermore, just as it is prophesied, God does the work of creation. There's also a confrontational war between God's army and Satan's army too. Yes, there is. This one book of Revelation brings to an end everything in the human world. From the time of Adam to the present day of Revelation, the prophecies and the words of prophets fulfill and end. With the fulfillment of the book of Revelation, God's purpose also comes to an end, and all our hope comes true. Living in this world today cannot be our Sabbath rest. If we achieve what God wants to achieve, that is, just like the word literally states, it will be paradise. It's the world of heaven that will fulfill. However, not all people can enter heaven. Also, even amongst believers, those who do not know, who do not understand, and do not believe in the things recorded in the book of Revelation will not be able to enter the kingdom of heaven either. Only those who hear the word, confirm the reality of it, and believe in it can welcome the Lord at his second coming as those with perfect faith, and can therefore enter the kingdom of God, heaven. That is why it is written, if one adds to or subtracts from chapters 1 to 22 in the book of Revelation, will not be able to enter the kingdom of heaven. It says so in Revelation 22, verses 18 and 19. As a result, the content of this one book is greater than the content of the other books in the Bible. This is the kind of book that brings closure to God's 6,000-year history in its entirety, everyone. Also, after God has accomplished on earth what was accomplished in heaven, heaven and this earth will unite as one, becoming a holy world where God can finally reign. Yes, it will be. Therefore, this is what we want to convey to the world, as it is what was seen and heard. Although whether one believes or not in their heart will be determined by those who perceive versus those who do not after hearing it. I hope that the religious leaders will listen, confirm, and believe so that we can serve God together in heaven and live together forever. Please listen carefully one by one with meaning. Please check and confirm again. I really would like for you to do so. Let's start with Revelation chapter 1. The book of Revelation was a revelation received and recorded by John. Whose revelation was his revelation recorded by John? It was the revelation of Jesus Christ, it says. And what does the word revelation mean? It means to open and to show. In God's Revelation, chapter 5, there is a book in God's right hand, sealed with seven seals, and God has possession of it. There is no one who can see or understand. Doesn't God have it in his hand? Yes. However, Jesus, he ends up taking the book, opens up the seven seals, and ends up opening all of them. Then what John saw was a vision revelation, meaning he saw revelation as visions and prophecies before they all fulfill, before the written revelation was fulfilled. So what was shown to John and what he saw was a vision revelation, that is, he just saw prophecies. However, today, I, along with the 12 tribe leaders, are not referring to vision revelations or prophecies. We are here to testify to the fulfilled reality, the fulfillment revealed through the prophecies in the vision revelation. Everyone, please listen really well. One might say religion this or religion that. But religion is not something that should be taken in vain. Religion is God's promise. What if God makes a promise and does not fulfill it? When God makes a promise, he fulfills what he promised, fulfilling everything about it without adding to or subtracting from it, even telling the one who sees, hears, and believes not to add or subtract from it either. So, with the revelation of Jesus Christ, it says, is what God gave him. Who is this him? God gave the sealed book to his son Jesus to open. That is why it was said to be a revelation of Jesus Christ. And the next content is that God sent an angel to John to show his servants what must soon take place. Then, this John, isn't he the disciple of Jesus? Yes, but at that time, it was just a vision, not the reality. At the time of fulfillment, the realities appeared just as recorded in the Word. That's what we call fulfillment. Since it is what will soon take place, what is it that will soon take place? It refers to the fulfillment to the prophecies of Revelation from chapters 1 to 22. It is also written that it is the servants who needs to be shown what must soon take place. The servants are the sealed 144,000 servants in Revelation chapter 7. The 144,000 belong to the 12 tribes, and there are 144,000 because there are 12,000 in each of the 12 tribes. It is to show these servants, which is why an angel is sent to give instructions. To whom? To John. The angel is sent to give instructions to John. Then, since an angel appears to give God's instructions to John, shouldn't John do the same? Yes, that is why it says John testifies to everything he saw. That is the word of God. What is it he saw? It's all of Revelation. Seeing everything, fulfilling everything. That's what he does. But there is something we should know here. Of course, this is a revelation of Jesus. However, God sent an angel to John to give him instructions, and John testifies to everything he saw and the word of God. If that's the case, John is the one who testifies, and God commands him to testify to everything that he has seen. Yeah. He is told to testify what must soon take place, the entirety of Revelation, to the servants, to the 12 tribes. The 12 tribes all fulfill in Revelation chapter 7. John testified to everything. That is what that means. Then who would God's promised shepherd be here? It would be John, right? Didn't God send an angel to John to instruct him? Of course, Jesus does a work of coming and uniting with him in spirit. However, the flesh, the shepherd whom God appoints and promised, however, is John. Shouldn't we know this? Who gives to his servant what? To give to whom? That means this person will receive it from someone. It's God who commands him. So it is to John the command is given, and John fulfills everything he is commanded and instructed to do with the word of God. What would be the word of God? The word of Revelation up to chapter 22 is the word of God. Also, he testifies to the word of God and everything he has seen. Right? Then there must be someone who received it and someone who delivers it. The one who testifies to everything that was seen and heard is John. Why? Well, didn't God give instructions to John through an angel? And John said that he testifies of the word of God and everything he saw. Then the promised shepherd is John, is it not? This is not using flattery, nor is it excluding Jesus either. By reading all of Revelation, one will be able to understand better. But in Revelation chapter 5, Jesus takes the book in God's hand, opens up the seven seals, and does the work of fulfilling it. Who is the person who saw the fulfillment from chapters 1 to 22? It's John. Yes, it's John. That is why it's John who testifies to everything he saw. I'm sure all of you remember Hosea chapter 12, verse 10. It says, God spoke to the prophets and told parables to them. Similarly, at the time of fulfillment, it is not Apostle John of the past. Apostle John already passed away. He's not here. That means there is a person given the duty like John who appears today. We need to think about this. We must know this. Another point that can help process this is what was recorded in Ezekiel chapter 3. A long time ago, Jesus came and ate the scroll that is seen sealed in Ezekiel 3, and he testified to it, didn't he? A long time later, Jesus received and ate the words of the scroll and testified to it. Reference Matthew 15, verse 24. Just like that, even today, Just as we saw in Revelation 1 verse 1 to verse 2, there is a person who receives a command. And in Revelation chapter 10, an angel comes with an open scroll. It was sealed scroll in God's hand. But after Jesus opened up the seals, the scroll is now open. Yes. The open scroll is then given to John. And John receives and eats that scroll. Therefore, the scroll goes from God's hand to the hands of Jesus, and then from the hands of Jesus to the hands of the angel, and from the hands of the angel to John, who receives and eats it. And John is then told to make this known to many peoples, nations, languages, and kings. Jesus also received, ate the open scroll, and testified to it. And this John also receives, eats the open scroll, and testifies to it too. That is why it is said that John is instructed from the angel. From Revelation chapters 1 to 22, all of this is being told to John. And John sees everything from chapters 1 to 22. Therefore, John knows the reality of the prophecies and who they are. Do you understand, everyone? All of God's work comes to an end in this one book called Revelation. In this book contains content of war and various other content as well. Also, God's people and His kingdom that is created in Revelation is also recorded in this book as well. It's created exactly the way it is recorded. Yes, exactly the way it's created. God's new kingdom and new people are created. This is not referring to the subjects of the kingdom who existed prior. Instead, they are those who are created at the time of Revelation fulfillment. They are God's 12 tribes. They are His family. Thus, shouldn't we know the truth and the reality to the scroll? Yes, we must know. Currently, even if prophecies seem grand and bigger than life, if they do not fulfill into reality, then there is no value in prophecies alone. However, today, Revelation is being fulfilled and the reality has appeared. What good is it just to have a scroll or a book? It must fulfill. So up until now, I've spoken up to verse 2. We will go into verse 3. It says, "Blessed is the one who reads the words of this prophecy, and blessed are those who hear it and take to heart what is written in it." It says, no matter how much is heard, and no matter how great the word is testified to, the one testifying must make sure to keep the word. If one hears a word of testimony but does not keep the word that's recorded, then it's completely meaningless. However, whether it's the one who testifies or those who hear the testimony, they should make sure to believe in the work that's recorded in the book of Revelation from chapters 1 to 22 and keep those words. That's what's being said, everyone. We should know this. So prophecies do not exist forever and remain as a prophecy. It fulfills. Why? Well, in John chapter 19, verse 30, Jesus said, "It is finished." What did he accomplish? All the prophecies of the Old Testament, that's what fulfilled. That is what was all completed. That's why he said, "It is done." Even Revelation, once all of it is revealed and fulfilled, that is when we can say it is accomplished, correct? The fact that the book of Revelation also fulfilled means that everything has already been completed in the spiritual realm. So in Revelation 21 verse 6, it also says that everything has been accomplished. So what God has already accomplished in the spiritual realm, He has already accomplished on earth, just as it is in heaven, which can be looked at as a rebirth or recreation. That's why it is done. It is fulfilled on earth just as it is heaven. Yes, these words are fulfilled on earth just as they are fulfilled in heaven. Yes, everything fulfilled in heaven also fulfills here on earth. That's why when God comes, it's not just only God who comes. In Revelation chapter 21, there is a holy city created by Jesus in heaven. It is that place that he brings down with him. The foundations of that city are the 12 disciples of Jesus. When Jesus left, he went to go prepare this place. But when the place is ready, he said he'll bring it down so that we could all live there together. Yes. In the same way, it is done on earth just as it is in heaven. And the things on earth is a shadow that has been created according to the blueprint of heaven. It's when the spiritual and the physical worlds are created the same, can the spiritual world come down to unite with the physical world? Yes, that is so. So what is the next content? If you read in chapter 1 of Revelation, you might think everything is already finished and covered in chapter 1, but that is not the case. In the content of chapter 1, John here sees all of Revelation from chapters 1 to 22. After seeing everything, he summarized all of it and came up with a conclusion, which is the content seen from verses 1 to 8. Yes. After he saw everything of Revelation all the way to chapter 22, from verses 1 to 8 in chapter 1, he came out with a conclusion. So from verse 4, it says that he's writing to the seven churches. This was referring to what John wrote in Revelation chapters 2 and 3. Today, there are the seven messengers who appear at the time of the end, just as Jesus said. That is why it said that letters are written to them. And he did not send letters to the churches of Asia. Today, at the time of second coming, there are seven messengers today. Yeah, just as we see in Revelation chapters 2 and 3. That is why it says he writes letters. Next, we see in verses 5 and 6, there is a mention of kingdom and priests. Who are these kingdom and priests? It is said that they are freed by Jesus' blood, it says. On the night of Passover, in Luke chapter 22, verses 14 to 20, Jesus mentioned his blood. The Passover meal is the flesh and blood of the Lamb. It is Jesus' flesh and blood. He said he will not eat the Passover meal again until his Father's kingdom comes. Then let's think about the Father's kingdom. As seen in Revelation chapter 5, verse 9 to 10, it is written that Jesus purchased people with his blood and made them into kingdom and priests. It is with Jesus' blood they are made. So kingdom and priests appearing in verses 5 and 6 are those who are freed from sin by Jesus' blood, everyone. So this is content that was summarized after seeing everything. It is the conclusion, which is why it's written this way. Now when we go to verse 7, when Jesus left, he was hidden by the clouds. What did the angel say at that time? When Jesus left, a cloud hid him from his sight. And at that time, he said, Jesus, he will return the same way he left. Then will we be able to see him or will we not be able to see him? The clouds hid him. So we will not be able to see him with our eyes. Because it says he will return the same way. But in verse 7, it says those who even pierce Jesus will be able to see him. Well, if those who pierce Jesus will be able to see him, maybe those who pierce Jesus, well, they have a spirit, so maybe their spirit could see him. However, today at the time of second coming, who are those who pierce Jesus? We can see a glimpse in Revelation 11. Also in Matthew chapter 25, it says, doing to the least of these brothers of mine is like doing it to Christ. That is why it is mentioned as those who pierce him will see him as well. John, he received a revelation while exiled to the island of Patmos. But Jesus, he appoints a man with a loud voice. At the time John is appointed, John starts to speak other than what is said up to verse 8. Jesus calls out in a loud voice. He turns around at that time and sees John sees Jesus walking among the seven golden lampstands, holding the seven stars in his right hand. Since those seven stars are in his right hand, are they the size of tiny beans? Everyone, there are things bigger than the earth. But we have to think about what it means he was holding seven stars in his right hand. These seven refer to not only the seven spirits, but it can refer to seven people. They were in his right hand. With the seven stars in his right hand, he walked among the seven golden lampstands. Also, the form of Jesus was not the same form that he had while he was on earth. Whether it was his head, his face, his legs, or arms, it was quite amazing. That means he did not have the appearance like that of a flesh. Instead, he was in spiritual form. It was not the same form he had when he was here as flesh on earth. Now he became a spiritual body. Yes, it was an amazing spiritual body. And that is not all. I was one who heard the words of Jesus. I've also seen his spiritual form. I've also heard the words of God and also have seen his image too. However, when I saw the form of Jesus, I was so afraid that I became like a dead man. I laid prostrate on the ground. Jesus, however, raised this John up. He sat me up, put his hands on my forehead, on my head, and introduced himself. He said he died long ago, but now he lives. And he explained how he has a key to Hades. Then he spoke the words, in verse 19, stating, "Write therefore what you have seen, what is now, and what will take place later." And he told me what the seven golden lampstands that I saw were, and he told me what are the seven messengers. Because it says that they are a mystery in chapter 19. But then regarding the seven golden lampstands and the seven messengers in verse 20, he explains what that means. So these mysteries were made known to this John. Furthermore, to this John, he was also taught who the organization of Satan was and what the mystery of the prostitute is. In Revelation 17, verse 5, and In addition, he was even shown the mystery of the last trumpet in Revelation 10, verse 7. That was also made known to him as well. That means everything was made known to this John, right? We are reminded of what Amos chapter 3, verse 7 says. It says, the sovereign Lord does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. Thus, what no one in the world knows concerning the group of Satan, the mystery of the prostitute, the mystery of the prostitute's beast with seven heads and 10 horns, all of this was taught to John. Are not these great mysteries? Also, even the mystery of the last seventh trumpet was made known to him too. What does it say regarding what will take place at the sound of the seventh trumpet? It is said that the kingdom of the world will become the kingdom of our Lord. Yes, the kingdom of the world becomes the kingdom of the Lord. What else does it say? That what is perishable will change at the sound of the last trumpet. Whether perishable will be clothed with the imperishable, and death will be swallowed up in victory. We see starting in Revelation 8, the trumpets start to sound one by one, and one is left to sound at the end. At the sound of that last trumpet, it says the kingdom of the world will become the kingdom of God. What is mortal will become immortal, the perishable will be clothed with the imperishable, and there will be change. Do you not want to know more of Revelation even after all this? Or do you believe it's okay not to know? 6,000 years of history are tied to this one book of Revelation. And if one doesn't know Revelation, one cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Where would you go to obtain these secrets? The mystery of the seven messengers. Furthermore, the mystery of the beast with seven heads and 10 horns. The mystery of the last trumpet. All of these mysteries were made known to this John, right? All these events were shown, including all the mysteries. If that's the case, everyone, shouldn't we receive the testimony of Revelation correctly from the person who has shown the entirety of Revelation and made known the mysteries from God? Isn't that receiving a true testimony? All pastors of the world, please think about this. Please ask yourselves these things. If you truly knew and understood Revelation, or if you saw the events of fulfillment, truly ask yourself these things. Shouldn't we try that? Let us not be those who are rude. Even if someone tries to deceive God, he cannot be deceived. We also cannot pretend like we know when we actually do not know. Do you see why I, along with the 12 tribe leaders, desire to make this truth known to all the religious leaders worldwide? Within Revelation, not only does it contain the path to heaven or hell, but also the path to life or death. We cannot fulfill our hope if we do not follow the word of God. Thus, everyone, I ask that you please listen well. Whether we care a life of faith or not, this is the one book we must know and understand. We must digest this one book, Revelation. There's an angel that brings the open scroll in Revelation chapter 10 that Jesus opened, and he feeds it to John to eat. Initially, the scroll was in the right hand of God, but there is no one in this entire world who could open or look inside it. But Jesus opens a scroll, fulfills it, and gives this scroll to John to eat. Then where is the scroll? It's now in the stomach of John, isn't it? Then if you just ask about Revelation to me, then you'll be able to understand the meanings, and you'll know the realities to the prophecies too. Why would you not want this? I believe you will want this. We should want to know what's recorded in terms of what will happen. What is the result? Shouldn't we know these things? Leaders, you guys have suffered a lot over the years. I know this very well. You have even faced so many hardships. But everyone, if one adds to or subtracts this book of Revelation, it says one cannot go to heaven. But how can one think they can go to heaven if we don't even know Revelation? This is not my own words. These are the words of God and Jesus. If they say that you can't go, then you can't go to heaven. That's why everyone, the reality of the word, the seven messengers Jesus appointed, you know, what's their name? What does their face look like? Would you know how to answer that? Leaders, everyone, do you know this? Would you know the answer to this? Yes, I know. I saw. I know all their names. I know everything. I even know the organization of Satan who invaded there. The organization of the Nicolaitans. Did I see it? Yes, I have. From Revelation chapters 1 to 22, I saw all the realities of the prophecies recorded in Revelation because they all appeared. And Jesus sent an angel to make known these mysteries to me. That is why I desire truly a heart to make this known to all the religious leaders of the world. So let's set a time so I can convey this to you. You know, bring your notebooks, your recorders, and please listen. All the 12 tribe leaders, they will go over each chapter of Revelation, one chapter by one chapter. Prophecy and its fulfillment. They will make known all of it to you. Our 12 tribe leaders, they will also introduce themselves, who they are, and furthermore, all the characters who appear in Revelation, they will make them known to you too. Not only just the prophecies in the Bible, but they will make known even the reality to you. Who and where is there a person who could testify like this? So, the evidence of this book of Revelation, all the fulfillment and the reality of the prophecies of Revelation, we want to make it known to the religious leaders. However, it's not possible to name all of them directly because defamation can follow. So you should know that, everyone, right? If we do things without sincerity and we do things arrogantly, then heaven and eternal life we hope for will go further away. Everyone, you know, when does eternal life begin? Jesus also spoke about eternal life. All religious groups talk about eternal life. When does it start? When do you live forever? We need to know. It is said that what is fulfilled in heaven will fulfill on earth. And in Revelation chapter 21, what is the holy city New Jerusalem made with? Jesus, he even said that he was going to leave to go prepare a place. And after he is completed, that place, he was going to come and take us to be where he is. Where is it? Because Jesus created it, it's a new Jerusalem. It's not the old. It is a new Jerusalem with the word new. It's a holy city, New Jerusalem. And who's the foundations? It was the 12 disciples of Christ. That's why it is the holy city, New Jerusalem, built by Jesus himself. When that's completed, Jesus said that he will come bringing down that holy city, New Jerusalem, with him. At that time, there must also be 12 tribes here on earth, just as it is in heaven. And there has to be 12 tribes born of his seed here on earth. That way, the heavens and the earth, in the same position, can unite and become one. That is why the holy city of heaven, God and Jesus, all of them come here. Yes, to the place made on earth just as it is in heaven. If you know what is fulfilled in heaven, then wouldn't you know what is also fulfilled here on earth? And if one knows, they have to create that same pattern here on earth, right? This is what we really need to perceive and what we really need to know. So here on earth, there is a work of harvest, sealing, and creating the 12 tribes. Even in heaven, Jesus and his disciples became the city of Jerusalem. That's not only in heaven, it's coming down here on earth. It's not only Jesus and the city of New Jerusalem coming, God's also coming too. And because God returns, just as we see in Revelation 21, verse 1 to 4, it says death and suffering, they will all disappear, no more pain. Not only that, but it says he will make everything new, all creation will be made new. So what kind of world will exist in the future? The world of sin will disappear, and God's holy world will be established. Now the devil who ruled for 6,000 years will disappear. And finally, it's recorded in Revelation chapter 19, starting from verse 6, that God will be the one to reign now at the time of Revelation. God is the creator. Is there anything God cannot do? No, he can do everything. Should we end our faith in vain? If they do, then they will go into the lake of fire. Why do we need to be thrown into the lake of fire? What's the purpose of our faith? Isn't it heaven and eternal life? Then when God comes, there will be no more death, mourning, crying, or pain. Then from that time, there will be eternal life, correct? Yes, at the sound of the last trumpet, there will be change. What is perishable will become imperishable. And what is mortal will become immortal. What is the last trumpet? The seventh trumpet, isn't it? Yes, the seventh trumpet. One must change at the sound of the seventh trumpet, and then we participate in the first resurrection. Do you not know? So silkworms, they eat mulberry leaves, and they become pupae, which then hatch and become butterflies, right? Today, we too must eat the word of God's truth, eat the fruit of the tree of life. We can't eat lies, fake, and the fruit of good and evil. Then our spirits will die. Yes, it will die. If you feed on any leaf or grass, it will die. Will it survive? No, it can't live. It's only by eating these words of God's promise, the truth, that one can be resurrected. Resurrection. Yes, resurrection is not about dying and getting sick. That's why we call it eternal life. If God exists, why would he watch his people die when God is reigning? This is the kind of world that will fulfill everyone. How much I really longed and yearned for this day to testify to the book of Revelation to the churches today. And what church will really accept me if I go there? I always pondered and wondered about this. Then together with the 12 tribe leaders, we can give videos where you can watch it in your own house. And we thought this is how we should convey this to the church leaders. And church leaders should also record this and pass it on to their congregation. Yes, are they not your own congregants? Yes, we should help them all so that they can all go to heaven. I really ask that you do this. Will you record it, share it with the congregants, and allow them to hear it as well? In Revelation chapter 7, it says that there are 12,000 in each tribe and 144,000 are sealed. And after a great tribulation, there's a great multitude. No one can count that will come out. But even the great multitude, they are freed by the blood of Jesus. Everyone, if you hear these words, believe and accept it, you can unite together with the 12 tribes here. When I went to every corner in various countries around the world, do you know what we said at the end of our speeches? We said, we are one. Yes, we shouted that we are all one. Those who hear this word and unite with this word, we truly have become one, isn't it? Yes, you can also sign an MOU too. It will always remain. Up until now, universities, high schools, and elementary schools, they are all signing MOUs and we are sending them peace textbooks. Ask them, all big countries. We are working together like this. You probably also know that there was a 40-year conflict with a religious war in Mindanao, Philippines, where 12,000 people were killed. Who solved that? Did the 120 million people solve it? Did the government fix it? Did the army solve it? No. But within a few hours, I was able to go there and help resolve it. If God is with us and Jesus is with us, then the words that come out of my mouth are not my own. It is God's words and it is Jesus' words. So in a short period of time, we were able to hold hands with each other and reach an agreement that we will never fight and insult each other ever again. And do you know what they did? They brought us a sickle where they melted weapons together in a fire to represent a sickle. Yes, they went this far and now we are doing peace movements together. Like this, if God and Jesus are with us, what is there we cannot do? Everyone, let's truly become one now, within God, within Jesus. Let us all become one and become the family of God. And let's serve God forever and live together in His kingdom. There's no sin in the kingdom of God. There's freedom. It's truly heaven. In order to deliver this message to you today, I'm standing here and preaching these words to you. Everyone, please make sure to record these words. Analyze and confirm and check each and every one of them. And please contact us. Please. Everywhere I go, I always give a shout out, and I will do so here too. In God and Jesus, we are one. Thank you very much. Yes, to God the Creator, Jesus, and also to the Promised Shepherd, the Chairman, let us offer up a loud round of applause to them one more time. Together, we will offer up a prayer to the Lord. Father God, who is truly holy, thank you for allowing us this precious time today so that people all over the world can hear the words of Revelation. Today, we heard the word of truth testified from the Promised Shepherd, and we received the testimony of Revelation chapter 1. Please help us not to be a path-like field where we get the word snatched away from the devil, but help us all to be good soil where we perceive and grow. Now, moving forward, the 12 tribe leaders will continue to testify to the words of prophecy and fulfillment to Revelation. We pray that the whole world will hear the word of truth, we perceive and receive the blessings of heaven and eternal life, Lord. The word of the Bible is all the work of war with the devil. Every time you did your work, there were so many obstacles. But now is the time to reveal everything clearly. So please allow all the people to fully listen and understand and make sure that no one falls because of the devil's interference. Please be with everyone who hears these words. And may you bless every family and every business, and please bless them with eternal life. Thank you so much for the grace you have bestowed upon us today. And we pray that even you will lead everyone to the next time so that everyone will listen to the word and understand. We pray all these words in the name of our living Savior, Jesus. Amen. How do you feel after hearing these words of life today? You look forward to the next episode, right? Next, we will watch the trailer video for Revelation chapters 2 and 3 that will be held this Thursday. Jesus gave to the one who overcomes the bread of eternal life. And also, God Jesus in heaven, it says, will be one with the one who overcomes. Also, in Revelation chapter 21, verse 7, it is said, the one who overcomes is the Son of God. Therefore, at the time of Revelation fulfillment, if we want to meet God and Jesus, we want to meet the one who overcomes, the promised shepherd whom God Jesus and heaven unites with. How did it feel listening to the word today? Do you feel refreshed thanks to the simple and clear answers given? The reason why Shincheonji Church of Jesus can testify to the words of Revelation so confidently is because not only the New Covenant Revelation, but even the prophecies and its reality of the four Gospels are all mastered by the promised shepherd who's here with us. Even the first coming, just like the 12 disciples, Shincheonji Church of Jesus' 12 tribe leaders received teachings from the promised shepherd and are the best lecturers who can testify to the fulfillment of Revelation. Going forward with the upcoming seminar Revelation, we will have each tribe leader go over each chapter of Revelation. This Thursday, Yi Ki-won, head of the tribe leader of John, will deliver the words of Revelation in chapters 2 and 3. The time will be just as today, 10 o'clock a.m. We hope that all of you will attend and come to understand the precious will of God and His promises. In addition to the message you heard today, if you have more questions or inquiries about the Shincheonji Church of Jesus and its doctrines, please contact the representative number of each tribe shown on the screen. We will guide you in detail and kindly. Now at this time, let us all finish by completing it with the Lord's Prayer. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, as we have also forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
This concludes the Shincheonji Online Seminar, Testimony on Prophecy and Fulfillment of Revelation, God's New Covenant. Thank you so much to everyone who joined us today.